Ladies and gentlemen, Scott Copeland right here.
Please put your hands together for Scott Copeland. Yes, please. Right. Keep it going for Scott Copeland. Keep it going. One more time. Keep it going. I really like how I get to come up here for nothing, and then I just sit here and play chords and listen to these great guys play, and I just sit here and smoke and drink and look cool and then walk away and feel like I've done something. You know what I'm saying? It's important. What? Armadillo song? Man, that's a long one. I don't know if I could pull it off right now. I could try.
You waiting to bring the house down with Country Girl. Saving that one?
Yeah, I'm saving Country Girl for the last because I know that's going to be a huge, huge, giant hit here. Even though Roger Ray totally disagrees with the direction that I'm taking with my lyrics. But I appreciate him pointing out to me how vulgar and crude I am and that I could be doing so much more with my life and my work. But one of these days I'll learn. Don't shake your head at me, man. Here's a little song I wrote. Y'all probably won't be able to play along with this, so if y'all just give me some leeway here for about 8 minutes.
I can do that.
For about 8 minutes.
Because I go many different directions. Anyway, I wrote this about I've got grouped into this Texas music thing, so I was trying to write a song so I could be more Texas music because seems like that's the way to go these days. And this is a true story. I was coming back from Amarillo, and it's totally true, so I hope you like it, and hope I don't fuck it up. Well, I was driving back from Amarillo, and I ran over an armadillo, and I was like, oh, fuck, dude, shit, goddamn. I think I just ran over a fucking armadillo. So I went back to investigate, and after further investigation, I realized armadillo was still alive. He said he needed a ride down I-35. He was headed to Austin. I was like, that is fucking awesome, dude. Then he said he had a friend, Possum, don't mind if he came too. And I said, can he talk? And he said, yeah. And I said, well, why fucking not? I said, hey, Armadillo, what's y'all's deal? And he said, hey, Scott, we trying to keep it real. We're Americana, alt country, folk, rockabilly, Texas, honky-tonk musicians. And songwriters. I was like, no way, dude, me too. We should start a band. So I said, well, why don't y'all play me a song? He said, here's one we've been working on. And then in two-part harmony, they both sing at the same time. The armadillo and the possum sang, I love Texas. I love Texas. I love Texas. I love Texas. And I was like, wow, dude, that is fucking brilliant. Why didn't I think of that? So I said, getting back to first things first, maybe we should write another verse to the song. I don't know, maybe something like this here. From El Paso to Luckenbach, Pearl Beer, Lone Star, and Shiner Bock. From Amarillo, Del Rio, the Frio, and the Rio, and Robert O'Keefe, Pat Green. My mother works at a Dairy Queen in Abilene selling refried beans, you know what I mean. Thank you. Then after they start digging us, we'll go get ourselves a bus and we'll do a big old tour of the west coast of Texas. On up into the panhandle, we'll wax them chumps like a candle. Dance, dance, fucking line dance, dance. Well, the possum played a damn good bass. It was low and mean, and he knew his place. And he never ever got too shit-faced, except for this one time in love. But that's a whole nother story. And the armadillo, he played rhythm guitar, and I played rhythm guitar, but it was okay because I used a capo. And then the possum, he said, dude, it's a bummer that we don't even have a drummer, because we could book gigs all summer, and I swear to God, we'd fucking rock balls. Then we passed a coyote and a horny toad. They were together standing on the side of the road, and wouldn't you know, that horny toad fucking played drums, dude. He was a big-ass horny toad. But not the coyote. The coyote was a roadie. He had this cool goatee, but most importantly, he could carry heavy shit. Man, that's a long song, huh? I'm doing good so far. I'm proud of myself. Then we stopped in Abbott, the hometown of Willie, and we went and had a bowl of chili and a dilly bar there at the Dairy Queen in Abbott, the hometown of Willie Nelson. Then we decided that we'd burn one down in honor of the man who wrote Angel Flying Too Close to Ground. Went to bed at 2 of the 10, woke up at 10 with a 2, and there's nothing I can do about it now. Then somebody said we should move along and maybe start working on that song that we were working on way back earlier in this song. Y'all can remember back, it was only about 6 minutes ago. Then somebody said they had a second part, but they weren't really quite sure how to start, but they thought it might could go something like this here. I love beer. I love beer. I love beer. Especially that smooth Shiner Bog Texas beer. Woohoo! In my mind, in my dream, everybody goes, yeah, Shiner Bog.
That's the wrong town.
Yeah, no, that's great, Scott. We love that Shiner Bog beer. Then somebody said we needed a name, something that would make us famous. And then Amos said, Amos is a coyote. And then Amos said, how about the Horny Dillo Possum Weedlanders? I was like, that's great, but shouldn't we say something about our state? And they said, well, how about the Lone Star Horny Dillo Possum Weedlanders? Woohoo! Well, that's it, I said. We're going to start raking in the bread and rocking and rolling until we're dead, or at least until we graduate from Oklahoma State. Then somebody said they had a record, man, but they, no, wait, shit, I was doing so good up until then. Then somebody said they knew a record man, that he really loved our band, and that he had this really good plan, seeing how we were so different, because we had singing rodents in our band. Nobody's had singing rodents in a long time, except the Bertsy Brothers. Muskrat. Okay. And he said that he had connection to Willie, and that he might could work out a deal where Willie Nelson would come in and sing on one of our records. So we found ourselves a studio, and we felt that we were all sure to go straight to the top of the Texas music charts. That's when you know you made it, dude. And then we set our gear up on the floor. Willie Nelson, he walked through the door, pigtails and all. Stole that from Robert O'Keefe, but that's okay. I stole a lot of other shit from him, too. He told me it was okay. So he stood up to the microphone. He said, hurry up, boys. I got to go home. What key is this song in? And we all said it's in G, and he goes, good. 2, 3, 4, I love Texas. I love Texas. I love Texas. I love Texas. And then when we were done, Willie let out a call and he said he's sorry, boys. He had to go play golf with Keith Richards and Daryl Royal. They had a threesome. And so here we are waiting on the release. They said it's going to be 1, 2, or 3 more weeks and that we owe them $250,000. I was like, God damn, dude, I only got 7. So I decided that I had my fill. I took my advance and I bought some wheels, and I told every motherfucker I met that I know Willie Nelson. Thank y'all for listening to that. I play it so much better when people listen. Okay, fuck. Ready? She rides horses, throwing around barrels, and then she fucked my best friend Daryl twice. And I said, goddamn, but she says, darn, and then she blew my brother in the back of the barn. Ain't that nice? 'Cause she's a cunt. Street girl. Yeah, she's a cunt. Street girl, she got her own kind of attitude, and she does about anything she wants to do, and she hates every single man in the world. Oh my God, she's a street girl. Uh-huh. And at the state fair, she won a belt buckle right after she sucked off my Uncle Ty. This is my favorite part. Then she shaved hard and the hair of her muffin, it smells just like Copenhagen snuff. I wonder why. 'Cause she's a cunt. A tree girl. Yeah, she's a cunt. A tree girl. She got her own kind of attitude, and she does about anything she wants to do, and she hates every single man in the world. She's a cunt. Tree girl. She wears rocket jeans and she stuffs in her booty, and she's had a lot of fun in the cabin for dooley, you better believe. She wears cowboy hats and cowboy boots. She likes two up the front and one up the shoe. Good grief. She's a cunt. A street girl. Yeah, she's a cunt. A street girl. She got her own kind of attitude, and she does about anything she wants to do, and she hates every single man in the world. She's a country girl. Yeah, take that. You like that? Huh? You want some more? Yeah, yeah, you know you do. Yeah, give it up, give it up. Stick it. That was so fucked up, man. Hey, man, let's fucking do something and get some shit done. Does anybody have any ideas of what's going on? I mean...